Hey now, Rodney Erdickson here with part 2 of how to simplify your Blogger BlogSpot default template in order to be as simple as possible. These were the results we had working simply with the options available to us in the Blogger dashboard. As you can see, although we did get rid of many of the elements that litter and clutter the page, making it look more like a blog post and less like a standard website, we still have certain things like the attribution, the home, this bar here, which we would ideally want to get rid of. Of course, we also have this huge gap here with nothing in it. How can we trim this? In order to do so, what we're going to need to do is plain the code, which is essentially editing the HTML. Now, let me warn you right now, editing the HTML can be a risky practice. By doing so, what can happen is you can render your blog with a simple delete of, let's say, one character in the code. You could render your blog invisible so that it will not be visible, and chances are, in order to fix it, you would most likely have to default to a default template and begin your work all over again, which is frustrating. For this reason, it's important that we make backups. So, first off, in the Blogger dashboard, in the template submenu, with the simple template of the new template selected, what we're going to do is, before we do anything, we're going to click on Backup Restore. And Backup Restore reads, before editing your template, you may want to save a copy of it. Geez, you think they would tell you this sooner. Okay, great. So what you're going to do is you're going to click on the Download Full Template button, at which point it offers you to either open it or save it. You're going to save. Here I've made a specific folder to work out of. I called it Backup. I'm going to save it. I already have a copy. Doesn't matter. I'm going to overwrite it. There we go. I now have a backup of the template as it is right now. So if anything should ever go terribly wrong, what I could do is I could go into Backup Restore. I can upload the template by browsing to the file and then clicking Upload, and it should restore everything back to normal. Once this is done, what we're going to do is we're going to do a two-tier level of protection. The first tier was downloading that XML file. The second is we're going to make a live copy and paste of the code. So, in order to progress, we're going to click on Edit HTML. If you don't see the code, like right now I'm seeing the code, I'm seeing a bunch of writing here, a bunch of code, and lines and line numbers. If you don't see this, there's a bug in the system. Sometimes you have to click back and have to click on Edit HTML again. Repeat this until you see the code. Once you see the code, what you're going to want to do, well, before I continue, let me just teach you a very basic element of HTML. Now, keep in mind, the last time I worked with HTML was the 90s, and I wasn't very good at it anyway. But just to say, here is a basic instruction that you will need to know in order to further modify this code. Whenever you signify a section, for example, the body of the document, which would be the main text, you call out where the section begins with the following term, if you will. You have open angular brackets, close angular brackets, and the title, or the section name, in this case it's body. Here you would have your code, whatever your code may be. And in order to signify that you are done adding code to that section, once again, open angular brackets, this time a forward slash, followed by the name of the section again, body, and close angular brackets. So what that means is that everything below this line is code for the body of the document. Everything above this line is code for the body of the document, and anything that falls here is no longer code for the body of the document. It no longer applies to the body of the document. The same thing can be said if there was code here. The code here does not apply to the body of the document because it does not fall between this, the opening of the body, and this, the closing of the body. Hopefully that was clear enough. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure this document is clear. Right now I'm working out of a Word pad. You might want to work out of a notepad or something of that nature. No big deal. And I saved a blank document called Backup Template. I saved it in the backup folder that I'm working out of. Backup Template. There we go. And what I'm going to do here is, with the code available, I'm going to click within the code. Just place a text insertion cursor. I'm going to hold Control and press A like Alpha. This highlights the entire code. With the entire code highlighted, I'm going to hold Control and press C like Charlie. This copies the code to clipboard. I'm now going to go into the document in which I'm taking notes, in this case my WordPad. I'm going to hold Control and press V like Victor. What this does is this pastes what I have copied to the clipboard, which is essentially a backup of all the code. And I'm now going to hold Control and press S like Sierra in order to save my document. So now I have a backed up accessible version of the code. So if anything should ever go wrong, what I can do is I could just copy all this code and paste it right in this window. Now, what's beautiful about the HTML editor in the new Blogger is that if there is a problem when you save your document, it will warn you, which is beautiful. If you use the classic version, you don't have this benefit unless you're using an external HTML editing tool. So this is very, very useful. Now, let me show you an example of an error. First of all, it's important to note that my main goal in this is to eliminate widgets. So, fortunately, they've placed a quick link to jump to widget. Here you go. And here's all the widgets. Blog 1 signifies the actual body of the blog. It actually signifies this whoop, whoop, can I highlight it? This whole section here, including image, including title. This is important to me. I want to keep that. So I'm not going to get rid of the Blog 1 widget. However, attribution, header and navbar, oh, I'm getting rid of those. I don't want them. What's attribution? Attribution is at the bottom where it says powered by Blogger. I don't want that. Going to get rid of that. What else? Header and navbar, I've pretty much disabled them. Navbar, I've disabled it. However, it and header still takes up space at the top, even though it's invisible. As you can see, there's this huge gap here, this huge ugly gap with nothing. I mean, is it better with nothing or with garbage littering my page? I'd rather empty space, but still, it would be best if we could get rid of it. We're going to get rid of it. So, let me show you that. First things first, attribution. Now, as you can see, widgets are contained in sections. So here we have B section, which leads to B widget, which is the attribution, and here is the closing of the section. Remember, opening of the section because there's no forward slash, and here's the closing of the section because there's the forward slash, so we know that this is the section. Let me show you what happens when there's an error in the code. Gonna do something. Ooh, what just happened? Yeah, by the way, when you click on things, sometimes it tends to expand them if they are compressed, so keep that in mind. If ever you click on something and a bunch of code just explodes in your face. Look what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna delete this line. And why am I doing this? To show you an example of when there's an error. All of a sudden it's saying, hey, this B section here, we're highlighting it in red. Why are we highlighting it in red? Because something isn't right. Something isn't closed. It shouldn't be section. What happens if we try to save it? Error parsing, line 1765. Here's the line. Column 14, the element type B widget must be terminated by the matching end tag B widget. If you remember, I deleted this tag, and this is why. Why did I do this? To illustrate what will show if there is ever an error. If there is ever an error as such, and you still go ahead and save the template and don't correct the error, chances are your blog will not display. It will just be, chances are, blank space, And as I mentioned, your code will be essentially corrupted. Unless you could find that exact error and correct it, what you'll most likely have to do is most likely have to revert to the default template and work your way back and reapply all of the modifications you made, which is no fun. So, what I'm going to do in this case, I'm going to hold Control and press Z. It puts back the... It essentially undoes the line I deleted. I'm going to save template. All is well. It's gone. Great. Okay, on to what I want to show you. Gotta delete these widgets. We don't like them. Blog 1's necessary. We need that widget. All the others don't need so much. Let's get rid of them. Attribution. Remember, you see bwidget attribution. Your instinct might be, well, I'll just delete the widget and the closing line for the widget. That'll solve it, right? Wrong, because it's contained in a section. If you do so, then the section remains. The template, when you try to save it, it'll say, hey, you have a section for a widget, but no widget. You know what? We'll fix that for you, and we'll just put that widget back in. Bad. Wrong. You got to delete the entire section. So, I went up one. It showed me by jumping to widget, I jumped to attribution. Boom. It shows me it right here. Here's the widget. Attribution. Gonna go up until I find a section, because that's where it starts. I'm going to highlight this. Begin at the beginning of the... open bracket, the open angular bracket, and I'm going to highlight going down, down, down until I find the closing angular bracket section, if you follow. So this opened the section, that's why I began highlighting here. This closes the section, that's why I ended highlighting here. And now I'm going to do something drastic. I'm going to press the delete key. Boom, it's gone. I just deleted the whole section, including the widget. I'm going to save template. Saving. It's reading the code, making sure there's no error. Didn't report an error. Now when I jump to widget, there's no longer that attribution section. It's gone. What happens if we preview? What'll it look like? Here's the reveal. Just to show you my backup. Powered by Blogger. I didn't want that. That's the attribution. I want it gone. No more powered by Blogger. It's gone. You don't have to see that anymore. Done. Next step, edit template. As I mentioned, the other two widgets, we want to keep blog 1, because blog 1's the actual body of the blog. We want to keep that. Header and navbar, we don't want them. I've made them as invisible as I can without going into the code. But what that creates is that creates that huge empty space right up here. And I don't want that. I want to get rid of it. Let's get rid of it. Jump to widget. Header 1. Here is the widget, header 1, and it is contained within the section. Here's the section. I'm going to highlight at the beginning of section. I'm going to go down, down, down. And now how I'm highlighting this, by the way, if I didn't make it clear, is I click before the beginning of the section, and then I hold the shift button, and I press the down arrow, and this highlights whole sections. Wherever my cursor is, forgive me, as I move the cursor arrows around. So I began at the beginning of the open bracket, right before the open angular bracket for section, and I ended right at the end of the close bracket for the closing statement of the section. And as usual, I'm going to delete, you go bye-bye, save template, see if there's any errors. No errors reported. Jump to widget. I don't see it here anymore. Let's preview. All of a sudden, I don't have all that headroom at the top. Beautiful. Edit template. Let's continue. Jump to widget. Navbar 1. Navbar 1's essentially invisible, but you know what? I bet you it's still taking up a bit of space up there. Let's get rid of it. Here is the opening widget line. And here's the closing widget line. It's contained within the section. We're going to begin at the beginning of the section, as with prior. Once again, put my cursor right before that angular bracket before the opening of the section. I'm going to hold shift, press down, 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 highlight everything, up until the closing bracket of the closing section statement. I'm going to press delete. Boom, you go away. It doesn't matter if there's added spaces, by the way. if this line right here begins at 533, or if it begins at 532, or if it begins at 531, there's no danger. Empty space is not computed into anything as far as code goes, so no problem. Save template. Saving. Done. Jump to widget. All we have is blog one yet left. Preview template. And there we go. Look at that. Nice and streamlined. My blog post begins relatively at the beginning of the page, at the top of the page, the way I wanted it. Just a title, just a some text, and an image, just the way I wanted it. Fortunately, I still have this to deal with, but no longer an attribution. Still pretty good. I've saved my template, edit template, save template. We're happy with that. Gonna click back. You finalize by clicking back after you save template, by the way. There we go. Saving. Let's see what happens in the blog, in the actual live version. In Opera, I'm going to Settings, Delete Private Data to make sure I'm not viewing a cached version of my page. roddixon.blogspot.ca. Loading. And here is the live version of my page. No longer is that terrible empty header space at the top. Begins with just the title, the text, the image, and no attribution at the bottom. Well, there you go. That is the way to remove the widgets from your Blogger BlogSpot blog by editing the HTML code. I hope this information helps, and as usual, all the best.